which makes her happy to have wood at hand for her wood-burning stove. So that's about it.
Good, good.
Yeah.
What about you, KK?
We went to pick out pumpkins today, and we took the little baby kitties and got pictures with them with the pumpkins.
You're kidding. That's funny. That's always fun. When are you guys going to stop doing that?
Getting
How
pumpkins?
About never?
Or taking pictures with the kitties.
Taking pictures with the pumpkins every year. Oh. Those are always some of my favorites.
Yeah, probably never. We got some really good ones this year. And they have the kitties in them.
Hey, here's a funny little secret that I haven't, I thought you might enjoy, KK. I forgot to tell you today. Well, I couldn't tell you today because Brant was there. I picked up another kitty this week, and B doesn't know about it because it looks like the other kitties.
He'll never know, huh?
He may never know. He was in the barn, and there were three tabbies instead of two. And he didn't even notice.
That's
so I'm going to see how long it'll take him before he figures out.
Oh, my goodness. That's so funny.
That's great.
But anyway, my positive focus was that I had a really good really good weekend. We didn't really have anything major to do, and so we just spent the whole weekend just doing whatever we felt like doing at the time and enjoying, and it was just really fun.
Nice.
And my other positive focus is that Caroline is coming next weekend. So excited.
I'm so excited. I just have to make it through this week. This is going to be like a really rough week. But then I have such a great, I'm going to have such a great time with Silver. So something to look forward to, which I'm also very excited for.
Yeah. Well, what about you, Kathy?
Well, I have a lot of positive focuses, so I'll just give you a snippet of each one. The first one is my grandchildren, all four of them, just left 5 minutes ago.
and that's your positive focus?
No. The positive focus was they were here all. They were here. That didn't sound good, did it? No, they were here all weekend. That's my positive
part. That's the positive part. Yeah.
But I had to put that boundary that I have a 6 o'clock call, so... but anyway, so that was my one positive focus. And then another positive focus, and you guys don't even probably know who Bill Curtis is, but he's quite the celebrity. I mean, he's an Emmy Peabody winning journalist. He was a news anchor on prominent TV station here in Chicago and East Coast for 40 years, so he's a big deal. And he's in our USANA business. And so USANA has assigned a senior writer to him because he's a person of, because he's a celebrity and because he's a person of influence. So they have begun the interview process with him, and it's going to be published in all the USANA literature, blogged. So it's huge. And that's a grand slam. And then the second piece of that, because of that, and because Bill is really interested in the publicity, we have strategized and really ramped up his USANA business in terms of outreach and growth. So that's huge. It's just really, really huge. And then my last positive focus is that because this is a business focus too, but because USANA is in 21 countries and the U.S. is the oldest, the growth in the U.S. is not, the percentage growth is not nearly as steep as those in like new startups, like in other countries, brand new startup, it takes off. So anyway, USANA is selecting late leaders in different areas of the country, and they've selected four in the U.S. to send out one of their executive mentors, and we've been selected. So we've got, and this is really to grow our business like huge in the next year.
Wow.
So he's coming out next month, and we're Carrie, Kyle, and I will be meeting with him, and then we'll be mentoring with him. And so he's mentored some of the greats within USANA. So we're ramped.
Yes.
Wow.
Should. Very
yeah.
good.
I'm excited.
Yes.
Wow, Kathy. That is awesome.
Thank you. Thank you. It is. It's really
that
great.
That is huge.
Mm-hmm. It is.
Now, is that about the, like, what professional success have you had that's on same caliber with that? Because that's huge.
None. Nothing. I mean, this is the big thing.
Did you guys capture that? That's the greatest thing. Like, that is the most impactful thing. Mm-hmm. Awesome, Kathy. That's so awesome. I want to make sure you capture that. Like, that is amazing. That's really, really amazing.
Yeah, we're very excited. Very, very excited. I mean, it's going to be a truckload of work, but it's going to be, I mean, we're ready. We're willing to do it, and we're great. So, I don't mean we're great. I mean, we're good to go.
Yeah. You're great, too.
Yeah, thank you, thank you. So, that's my stuff.
That's fantastic. My positive focus this week, I got to spend a really good week last week doing a lot of really cool meetings with really great people. Just got connected to a lot of really cool people, and I finally kind of captured like all the people that I was meeting last week. I would have never really had, or I had not previously had kind of the opportunity to meet up with a lot of them. So a lot of them were like old people kind of through my mentor in Chicago, and just kind of through EO, and just like a lot of like just really cool opportunities, where at the end of the week I was pretty exhausted. Like I was completely out of it, but man, it was really intense and very, very cool, and just something that I felt really blessed afterwards to be able to do.
That's great. That's great. So what's the focus? Where are you going with all of those contacts?
It's hard to say. A lot of them went into a lot of different directions.
Okay.
Most of them had to do with the business, and just kind of ramping it up and like taking it to much larger scales, like much bigger stuff. Like one of them, even for example, I'd even mentioned like we go online with Groupon Tuesday or Monday at midnight. We go Groupon nationally.
Great.
So we made it
That's
through
huge.
The through the well, it's huge in the way of like our sales were four times what the normal volume was in a week, just by that test market. And the test market was, the national market is over 15 times the size.
Oh,
so we're expecting like a 60-fold growth or a 60-fold increase in traffic this week.
You're right, right.
That's fabulous.
So, good.
So this is when everybody gets really excited. And then I bring the questions up of, hey guys, you know if the website can even handle 60 times the amount of traffic?
Mm.
How's customer service? You think Brian can handle all those calls? Mm. You think we can respond to all the emails we get? Mary, you got literally 10 times the amount of like requests through like group sales of things that were cross-selling, not for what we had in Groupon, but just through other things that people wanted. That was 10 times what you normally handle. Now you're looking to go up 15 times from that. Can you handle that? They hadn't gotten quite that far. But we're all very, very excited now because it's going to be intense. We'll see how it all works out.
Well, that's great. That's
good.
What you're working for.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah. That's great. That's great.
So we'll see. Lots of good things.
Yeah.
So, Jeez, Dad. Dad, I like that you don't have a whole lot of background noise for me this time. It's pretty good.
Yeah.
Yeah, you got new headphones.
Got new headphones from Dina. She says that she's fine-tuned this machine to make it this way.
Tell her it's work. It worked beautifully.
Yeah.
Very good. Very good.
So Kay, tell us, what do you think about this John Maxwell fellow?
Well, I thought he was very passionate.
Well, that's a good word for him.
Yeah. Yeah. Okay. But real quickly before we start, I only have till 8 o'clock, just so everybody knows. So.
Okay.
Let's do it.
So, the two challenges in life are to find ourselves or our purpose, and then to lose ourselves. And our purpose is bigger than us.
Who's the singer? Can you guys hear a singer?
Yeah, who's singing?
DJ.
Huh.
Kathy, do you know about my singer?
No. Do tell.
It's like a radio you can't turn off.
Aw.
Yeah.
That's cool.
You just belt it out.
Hey, what did you take away from that?
Me?
Yeah.
Take away from this video? Okay. Passion is a great energizer. It reminded me of a retreat I was on 2 years ago, I think. Where we talked about our natural high, and it reminded me kind of that. That's like your natural high, your natural energy, like a great energizer is your passion.
So you at your retreat, you thought about something that just naturally just made you on top of the world. And then you were able to figure out that, hey, that was something I was passionate about.
Yeah, it was a retreat for Teen Institute, which is against drugs and violence and alcohol and stuff. So that's why we were talking about that. But yeah, it was kind of stuff that you like to do a lot. That yeah, it was your passion, and give you a natural high.
Gotcha.
Also related to how if you don't have passion for something, it just takes away your energy. It doesn't give you any energy.
Drains you.
Yeah.
Yep.
Dad, do you have any examples of that?
Just the one he gave, when he was counseling, and it took all the energy away from him. But yeah, we all experience that in life.
Mm-hmm. You experience that while counseling, Dad?
No, not when I counsel, no.
No, I mean, are there any examples of you can think of in your life?
No, I'm upbeat all the time.
I think I noticed it when I would have to study at college, and I'd call Dad on a Sunday, and I'd go, I hate studying, and he'd go, well, I'm in the office doing book work, so, and neither one of us were, I guess, passionate about those things, studying and book work, so it was kind of tough.
Now, think about that. Now, Grandpa doesn't do any book work, and now he's upbeat all the time, meaning he always does what he likes to do. So he's always full of passion. How awesome is that, huh?
And I do the book work, and I don't mind it at all. I like to organize it and make sure that it's put together. I think there's something about what was it? Working with your strengths in this video.
What? Was there something like that? Hold on.
Something like God-given gifts.
What was purpose? Purpose was there were two things that went into purpose. What was that again? Anybody remember the two things that went into purpose? Caroline?
Your strengths and gifts.
What?
Strengths and gifts and passion. That's three.
Because strengths and gifts are the same thing.
Yeah.
So those two things. So what you really like to do and what you're actually good at.
Guys, it reminded me of my dad, because he loves to sing and dance, and it's bad. Guys, you should. Okay, we're driving to school this week. We have three people in our carpool: me, Rachel, and Drake. And we're driving to school, and Dad's in one of his moods, you know.
And busting it out that front seat.
Yeah, no, he's like, all right, so we have to find a song that we can all sing together before you guys have to get out and go to school. And I'm like, Dad, no. So he's switching through the stations trying to find a song for all of us to sing to, and he finds the national anthem. And Rachel's a freshman, so she doesn't know any better, but I'm a junior, and Drake is a sophomore, so Rachel and Dad just start singing the national anthem the entire way to school, and me and Drake are sitting there like, oh my gosh, it's so bad.
Anyway, yeah, but it was fun.
That's fun. I think that's great.
It was fun, but it was bad.
It was great.
Anyway, so it just reminded me of things that people really would like to be good at, but aren't.
Well, consider this, Kay. I heard the national anthem all the way to Chicago and back. If you think it was bad just going to school,
well,
because my radio I couldn't turn off.
Oh no!
Oh yes.
And I bet he loved every minute of it secretly.
Yeah. Okay.
That's funny. Anyways.
I liked when he said, passionate people do it anyway. When it's not reasonable, they do it anyway. It's not possible. Passionate people do it anyway. And it's true. And I liked that part, and then I was thinking about just anybody that's excited about things or high energy and high passion, people want to follow them. So it was nice that he had in there that you may not have something that you're super passionate about, but that's okay. You can, you know, like you may not be the leader, and that's totally cool.
Yeah.
Like, you just teamwork. What did he say? Teamwork equaled what? I don't remember what he said. It was something really cool. Everybody liked it. Was, you know, just really, really valuing teamwork.
It says teamwork